Hello dear students, welcome back to this session. In this session we are going to start a new chapter, that is the third chapter of 8th standard, database management in Microsoft Access 2010. So let's begin with the introduction part. When data is processed, you get relevant information. So dear students, in order to get the information from any system, the data should be processed first. As soon as the data is processed, you get the information that you want. If you observe carefully, you will find that organizations maintain data depending on their needs. So different organizations such as schools, large institutions, companies, they maintain the data. Data of what? Data of the employees, data of their assets, and data of their liabilities, etc. Example, we will see. A school maintains data about teachers, students, books, etc. So in a school, the data which is related to the teachers, like teacher name, teacher ID, and which subject he teaches, this data is maintained in the record book of the school. Okay, and school also maintains the data of students, books, etc. A company maintains data about employees, hardwares, etc. So the company maintains data about employees, such as employee name, his designation, like HR or senior employee, junior employee, etc. And the company also maintains the record of hardware, such as number of printers the company has, the number of monitors, computers, etc. Now, what does it mean by database actually? Database is a collection in table format or tabular format. So, a database helps you to organize the collected data in a tabular format. Whatever data you collect, okay, whatever data you collect, it can be organized. Okay, it can be organized in a table format or in a tabular format. Tabular means with the help of table you can organize the data. It is called as what? It is called as database. Okay, so database helps you to organize your data in table format or tabular format. It allows you to enter, access, and analyze the data. So database allows you to enter the data in it, to access the data of the database, and to analyze, means to observe, to analyze the data of the database. Which are three particular actions that you can do with the database? You can enter the data. See here, you can enter the data in database, you can enter new record in, you can add some records, right? You can access the data whenever and wherever you want, and you can also analyze the data, right? It also helps you to retrieve the required information easily. Whatever information you want, you can get it very easily within a second, right? Using the database. So database helps you to retrieve the information very easily. Therefore, the data in the database should be updated regularly. What does it mean by updation? Whenever you make changes, you save those changes. Okay, right? So you have to update the data in order to access the data, right? Next is your components of database. What are the components of database? We will see with this example. There are basically three components of database. The first component is table, second component is field, and third one is record. We will see one by one. A database consists of following components. First one is table. What is a table? Table is a collection of data arranged in the form of rows and columns. Now, dear students, you can see here, these are the rows. Okay, these are the rows, right? And these are the columns. See, these are the columns. Which one? See, this is a column, and you can see this is also a column. This is also a column. These are the columns, right? So table is collection of data which is arranged in the form of rows and columns. Now, what is a row? Just now I have shown you, row is series of horizontal cells. So see, these is a series of horizontal cells. All the cells are arranged in horizontal manner, right? So this is a row, correct? These are the rows. These are two rows, correct? Now, what does it mean by column? Column is a series of vertical cells, right? So you can see here, this is a column. It is a series of vertical, and this is also a column, series of vertical cells, a column, series of vertical cells, right? Horizontal means row means horizontal series of cells like this, and column means vertical series of cells. Now we will see what is field and what does it mean by record. Field, first of all, we will see a column in a table is called as field. Now, dear students, you can see in the example that we have taken, there are three columns. First column is student ID, second column is student name, third column is student address, right? Third column is student address. There are three columns. So each column is called as a field. Now, student ID is actually a field. It is a field. In this field, different student IDs are there. You can see 1001, 1003, 1008. These are the different student IDs, right? This field is student name. Now, in this field, student name field, we will write only the names of students. We cannot write the student IDs over here or the addresses of the student over here, because this field is student name field. And this field is student address field. Here we will write only the addresses of student. We cannot write here names of student and IDs of student. So the next point is, the information within a field will be the same type. Means we are writing student ID here as a field name. We can only write the IDs of student. We cannot write the names of the students. This field is student name. We can only write the student names, and here student addresses are written. Fine. So the information within a field will be of the same type. Example is given. The field called as student ID will consist of all the ID numbers of students. It cannot contain other type of data. It can only contain the student IDs. The field with the column header as student name will contain only the name of the students. Getting my point? So there are how many fields? There are three fields. First field is student ID, second one is student name, and third one is student address. Now, after field, we will see record. A row in a table is called as record. Now you can see, this is a record, right? However, this is a record. This is a record. How many records are there? Tell me, students. There are three records. This is first one with the student ID 1001, student name Akash, and student address is Pune. This is one record. This is another one, and this is third one. So each cell in a row is a part of that row. You can see 1008 is a part of record, third record, right? Sunil is a part of third record. and Nagpur is a part of third record. Similarly, 1001 is a part of first record, Akash is a part of first record and Pune is a part of first record. So basically, a single row of the table is called as record. Remember this point. Example is given, 1001 Akash Pune is a complete record of student named Akash. So when I click on this particular row, it gives me complete details of Akash. The student ID of Akash is 1001. The name is Akash and the address is Pune. So this particular one row is one record. Second row is second record. And similarly, the third row is the third record. I hope, students, you have understood the concept clearly. So we will stop here. That's it for today's session. Thank you. Bye-bye.